महा कार्टून टीवी।
Ghost Hut. In a village named Simapur, Shubham lived with his mother Badami and father Gopal. A woman named Saloni used to live in the hut adjacent to the hut of Shubham years ago. Saloni had committed suicide in her house because of poverty. And even after years of her death, no such incident happened that made villagers suspicious. But a few months ago, certain incidents took place that started to bother the villagers. During the night, some strange sort of noise started to come from that hut. And to top that, sometimes a few notes written with blood were found outside that door. A warning: leave my village. The villagers were now terrified of these activities going on around them.
Brother Ghanshyamlal, we have to do something about this witch soon, or else she will finish us all.
We have tried everything, all sorts of charms and spells, but this witch doesn't leave the village.
But we have to think of some effective solution. My wife and I cannot live in this fear that the witch can come to our house at any moment from her house all night long.
I understand, brother, but what else can we do to combat that wicked witch?
Look, brother, I don't know anything. We have a kid at our home. And besides, you too think about yourself. You have two kids at your place. Here everyone have a little innocent life living in every family. We have to think about them as well.
Everyone was just talking about ongoing incidents in the village. Just when a man named Pushpak comes there. Pushpak had no child of his own. Even after a lot of attempts over the years, his wife Seema and him couldn't bear a child. Pushpak adored kids, and that's why he considered all the kids of the village as his own. Even the children adored Pushpak a lot and regarded him as their uncle.
The situation is critical. It's not about us, but it's more about the safety of kids for me. We will still manage, but the kids, they are innocent. We have to figure out something immediately.
Uncle, you please don't stress so much. We will unanimously fight that witch.
I know that you all are very smart, but this is the matter of elders and not yours to be stressed, okay?
So what? Now even we have grown up, we can help.
Indeed, you have grown up a lot, but even then this matter is of the elders. You guys just focus on your academics and sports.
I have heard a lot about Saint in Haridwar, Saint Munish. Why don't we discuss the issues with him and try to find a solution?
Haridwar? But it's very far. How will we manage?
Okay, I'll go there by myself and talk to him.
Saying this, Pushpak left for Haridwar the same day. But in the evening, something strange happened in the village that blew everyone's mind.
What has this happened with me? My son.
What happened, sister? Why are you crying?
He's missing. He hasn't returned. On asking his friends, I got to know that while playing, he went inside that creepy hut.
On listening to this, everyone got scared. Nobody knew what to do. The situation was worsening now. Even the villagers now preferred to keep their children inside their homes. But steadily, all the children from the village started to go missing. In just 3 days, almost 12 kids went missing from the village. When Pushpak uncle returned to the village, he felt a big jerk on listening to this news. On seeing Pushpak there, the villagers could see a ray of hope for a better tomorrow and waited for him to say something.
The saint has told me about something that I can take help of to finish that witch. We can just hope for the best.
The saint had given a few spells to Pushpak to combat that witch. And also, he could talk to her, And after that, without wasting any more time, Pushpak straight away went to the hut, where the entire village waited for him to come out. It had gotten really dark and very late in the night, but Pushpak did not come out of the hut. But then the villagers saw something. Seeing such a painful sight, the villagers were terrified. Nobody was able to comprehend that what just happened with them.
Uncle! Pushpak uncle! Are you all right?
How did you get so many bruises on your face?
We have to immediately shift all the kids from the village, or else this witch will kill all the innocent kids.
Hearing this, the villagers were terrified. Pushpak told them that the witch is extremely aggressive at the moment. She is upset with each and every person in the village. She says that she kept dying because of poverty, and not even one person came forward to help her. And now she's back to take her revenge from every member of the village.
We have to do something and anyhow shift these kids somewhere safe from the witch.
The villagers started their preparations to shift the kids to an adjacent village. And seeing everyone panicking, Seema came there and said,
"Please don't panic all of you. I'm sure the kids will be safe. I'll do one thing. I'll talk to my auntie about keeping these kids safe and we can shift the kids there. Her house is pretty spacious."
"But who will take these kids to the auntie's house? We can't let them go alone so far."
"I'll take them."
Alright, Mr. Gopal, do one thing. You please go with them to auntie's house."
"No, I'll go by myself. You guys stay here and fight that witch."
"Uncle, I don't want to go anywhere. I want to stay here with you."
Shubham was reluctant and he refused to go anywhere from the village. After which, Pushpak asked Seema to leave from there with other children. And so, she left from there on a lookout. And once she was gone from there, an awkward silence had taken over the village. And Pushpak uncle said,
"Okay Shubham, listen. Now it's time to execute what I ask you to. Go, get to the work immediately."
The villagers were all left puzzled. Nobody knew what was happening with them. But it did feel as if Pushpak had prepared some sort of trap. In some time, Shubham came running from the other side and whispered something in his ears. After which, Pushpak asked everyone to accompany him somewhere. Everyone blindly trusted him and started to follow him. And in some time, they reached the jungle, where they saw some light coming out from a cave. He asked everyone to enter the cave, where what they saw blew all their senses. The sight in front of them was terrifying, that nobody could believe their eyes. Just when Seema saw everyone in front of her.
Pushpak, you?
Yes, me. I didn't know that you were behind all these acts.
It isn't. What it looks like. Trust me.
You don't have to continue with your drama anymore. Just confess your freaky reality.
What reality are you talking about? It isn't what it looks like. Trust me, the witch is doing it all.
There is no witch anywhere.
What? There is no witch? What are you saying? Also then, where did you get all these bruises from? Also, you went to Haridwar, right?
I wasn't in Haridwar. I was here only. Just didn't come in front of anyone. Because I already had an idea that whatever events were happening in the village, there is a human behind them, not a witch. When I got those blood written notes tested, I found out that it wasn't the blood of those papers. Rather, it was a color. And use of colors means human activity.
Pushpak told everyone how and what happened in the hut. He did go inside the hut, but just for the sake of investigating what exactly was going on in the hut. And there, he found a box of paint, a few packets of biscuits, and some pieces of coal. It was now obvious that it was a human behind all these activities. Pushpak then hit himself and threw himself out of the hut to make it look like he was attacked.
So now tell me, why were you doing all of this?
It was because we have been trying for so long, but we are not able to conceive. So I talked to a saint and did as he asked me to. And when I got to know about that dead woman named Saloni, so I thought of scaring the villagers by becoming a fake witch, so that I could kidnap all the children from the village and hand them over to Saint. I wasn't about to kill any one of them. And he said that he will organize a big ceremony with these kids for us. And if he will do like this, then we soon will be blessed with a child.
First of all this is a myth. And secondly, the saint made a fool out of you. He was about to sell all these kids. I read a news about him yesterday.
What? Is it true?
Yes. Now you better apologize to the entire village for what you have done.
Seema realized her mistake and she felt guilty for doing what she did. And so she apologized to the villagers for her deeds. And not just that, she also returned the kids that she had abducted before to their respective parents. And this way, Pushpak uncle used his brains and saved the life of all his dear kids. And since that day onwards, everyone started to address Pushpak as Pushpak uncle. And everyone started to live happily ever after.
If you enjoyed this video, do like, share and comment. And to be the first person to watch our videos, make sure to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for timely notifications.